Okay, folk, Roger Real Deep Cool here, and by the grace and permission of FC Kerbeck and their fine managers and definitely their sales executives, that they gave me the opportunity to come up here and film for you guys some of the finer cars that, you know, maybe one day you'll be able to afford. I don't know anything about these cars, but I want to expose them to you guys because a lot of you people don't have, you know, kind of access to this. A lot of folks don't have access to this fine establishment. FC Kerbeck been here for years. Can't even tell you how long I know FC Kerbeck has been here, but they've been here for quite some time. And they specialize in not only Cadillacs and Fords and, you know, other cars, they also have a fine car division, super fine car division. As you can see right here, we're looking at, it's called the Wraith. And this is a 2014 Rolls-Royce Wraith. And we won't get into the prices because, you know, basically I just want to show you the cars just briefly while I'm up here. I don't want to take up too much time, but just show you some of the cars. Now, I know I am not wrong about the Rolls-Royce having a new coupe out. I already knew that was happening, and this is such a beautiful car. You know, never knew that Rolls-Royce would actually come out with a coupe like this. Almost has a Bentley styling, but it's definitely much more. And of course, this is handmade, and BMW, of course, has something to do with this. Name of this car, I think it also would be a Wraith, but like it's a two-tone, and no one does two tones, okay? And there's a 2014 Rolls-Royce Wraith. And again, well, okay, we're gonna go medium 300s for these vehicles, medium 300s. Now, see how both these cars, they have the handles in the front, so that means it's probably gonna come out to being like a open out vehicle, to open the door, almost like a suicide door from the front. So I think that's a very exciting way to how you doing?
How you doing? I'm Joe.
How you doing, Joe?
Good. How can I help you?
A young man gave me, I told him apart, I have like a fragrance channel. I have like a big YouTube following. And I want to come up with a fragrance and style channel as well. I'm also a musician from Philly. I'm also a producer. I work with a lot of artists there. So in starting my new, well, my channel's been around for about a year, but, you know, being a fragrance reviewer and so on and so forth. I want to also expose people to like my style channel. Mm-hmm. So it goes from dressing well and finer cars and finer things. So pretty much what I want to do is have an opportunity just to come up. Let's check out the cars, not really try to sell anybody any cars, but just to show them what the cars look like, because it's rare. Like people in Oklahoma and Nebraska that follow me, whatever, they don't have a chance to look at cars like this. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to give them an opportunity to see cars like this, you know, because you guys have been here for years.
Great.
You know, so I wanted to just do this for my Lucha channel. I can't review the cars because I never had one before, so I can't say, well, this car does this, but just expose them to them and give them an idea they can't be able to see it for themselves from me. Mm-hmm. So a normal, common, septa working guy who just happened to be a recording artist as well. Good. So that's what I want to do.
Good. Enjoy. Okay. Take your time and have fun.
And I had a card I want to give you. It's probably lost. If I find you, you'll be downstairs, right?
Yeah, I'll be downstairs.
Okay, I'll come back down.
All right.
Enjoy. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Okay, and I just got finished talking to the manager of this floor. His name is Joe, and a very nice young man. I don't want to call him young man, but I am probably older than he is. But, you know, he gave me out, you know, I didn't want to come here. I wanted to get graces to come in and actually film this. I just want to come up into someone's establishment and start filming things. So I wanted to make sure everything was okay. As you can see, there's another Rolls-Royce with suicide doors. This is the Ghost. Four-door Ghost, suicide doors. And again, totally a high-end car, as you guys will know. But I know, like, even myself, I haven't seen the coupes up front. This is the first time I've ever seen the coupes up front, okay? And this is a Ghost. This is a 2011 Ghost. Again, not going to get into the price of it because it's neither here nor there, really. But just want to give you guys opportunity to see cars close up like this. I was actually on my way, you know, to pick up my new watch. And I decided, let me stop because I wasn't coming back this way. Usually I would come back this way to go home, but I didn't want to come back this way today. I'm going to North Philly after I'm done. So I decided to come this way. Again, you have your Rolls-Royce Ghost. This is 2015, so just super brand new, just about. Suicide doors, of course. Rolls-Royce emblem. And again, handmade car, totally handmade. And BMW, as you know, that's what I drive, has a lot to do with the building of Rolls-Royce. Hey, what can you say? Now we're moving over to the Bentley section. And I really like Bentleys. My favorite are the coupes. As you can see, this is a black on black with a black gut. And pretty much, the thing about these vehicles, as much as I like them, it comes with warranty. Now, for somebody like me, of course, the warranty is going to be unbelievable. You get 2 years, but it's not going to cover everything in particular. FC Kerbeck, again, is where we are. Now, this car is a coupe. It's $240,000. Okay. Now, believe it or not, I know a friend who has one of these. He has a real used one. It's like a 2008. And you can't imagine having what the warranty is on this car. This is a W12, by the way, 12-cylinder. What the warranty would be on this car. And also, if you decide to keep it past 2 years, because anything that's covered is 2 years, 24,000 on these cars. So if you can't afford the warranty and the upkeep, these wheels and tires on my car is $1,500. Imagine what the wheels and tires are on a Bentley. So you can't go getting these cars think you're just going to be styling and profiling around unless you have a bank account. And of course, you're ready to fix the car, okay? Now you see, this car actually has a previous damage history, and they let you know. But, you know, it's a limited warranty, and they'll pay 100% parts and so on and so forth. For a duration, doesn't really say. But it probably won't be that long, not the two-year standard, unless you buy a two-year standard warranty. This is a Bentley Flying Spur, 114,000. Again, only 3,300 miles, but again, it was involved in a little situation. And this car will only be covered for a minute. I mean, with 3,000 miles, but it's 2010, so any warranty possibly is over with this car. So you want to make sure that you do have the apparatus and the financial status to handle this particular situation here if you get into this car. All right, I'm gonna handle these other cars on the way out. Again, this is another. I'm not sure. I'm not even going to ask what it is. I'm just gonna wait till we get there. Okay, it is a Flying Spur. I wasn't sure. 2006, 69G. Now, some guys will look at this and say, okay, well, my car was like 64. So while I can come over here and I can get into this, a 2006 is 48,000 miles, but once it rolls out of here, who's gonna take care of it? Who's gonna take care of the warranty on this car? What is the insurance gonna be like for me? Even though I live in pretty much a better part of the city right now, what would the insurance be for them to insure this car? If this car is $69,000, probably not that much. It probably could be about the same as mine. But because where you live, if you live in North, or so on and so forth, we live in one part of the city, it's Red Line, you can't get this car. But again, back to my buddy, he picked up one, it's used, I'm not sure what the other situation is, but if anything ever happened to that car, my man got to work. And I don't know if I want to work just for the upkeep. I learned that from Porsche and having a Porsche Boxster S, I learned that as well. When it was time to change the rotors, because it was mandatory that you did that, when it was time to change the rotors and everything, man, it was very expensive and it wasn't covered on the warranty like BMW. This is a 2012 GTC W12. And of course, again, once you roll out, it'll come out with a warranty, but it's not gonna be long. So you better grab your warranty. This is 8671 for the miles, so that's not bad for this car. It's barely been driven. But even at 169,000, can't imagine finance under 69. You're talking about almost $2,000, $2,500 a month. Do you want to pay that kind of money if you don't really have it and you just want to live above the life? That's ridiculous. You know what I mean? But I'm not showing you these cars to even give you an impression that I'm thinking about it. I just want to show you guys what this car is. Now, would this car be in my future for some reason or other if I'm in a position to own one? Then, of course, why not? Why not? I would take a Bentley, I would roll it around for the 2 years, make sure it's new and it's covered for the 2 years, and then I would make sure in my lease that if I get out this car, they're going to take good care of me, and you put me in another one, and I can stay on the road with BMWs like I am with leasing stay on the road with Bentley like I could with a BMW, just always staying on top. Look at the curves of this car. This is a pre-owned car. Look, see, this one I'm talking about lines. Do you see that? Do you see the detailed lines on this vehicle? This is another Flying Spur. Let's see. This looks like it's going to be... I don't see the year on it. But it's in the pre-owned section, so I'm sure it's probably not a new one. But it's a gorgeous car. I mean, just looking at the lines going down it. Do you need to have this car if you're working as I work for Scepter? Do I need this? No, I don't. Why? It makes no sense. I couldn't even sleep. I would think every day somebody's trying to get in my car or looking at my car, putting their hands on it, touching it, scratching it because they just can't stand the fact. I mean, I've had that happen just on my BMW. When I first got my BMW, there's so many scratches on my BMW the first week that I got that car. It was unbelievable. You can't get a new car around my job because there are a lot of people that just ain't going to appreciate it. I had a dude come up and say, yo, man, everything was cool, man, till you shit on everybody with that BMW X5. And at that time, it was the highest thing. I mean, it was the most expensive thing in a lot. It was the most expensive thing any employee that was at Fern Rock anyway. But I didn't buy because of that. I bought that because it was a great buy. They gave me a great deal. I knew it was covered under warranty for my lease, which is 3 years, $36,000. And I was good to go. Actually, my lease is 3 years, $30,000, because that's what I took as far as mileage on my lease. You know, so look, people are going to do what they're going to do. I don't have no time for that. I still got to live my life. You're going to scratch my piece up. That's okay. That's what insurance is for. If it get bad, I just blame it on whoever did it. If I catch you. Anyway, here we go. Now we go over here to the, I think these are the new Bentleys. And as you can see here, you can tailor-made your Bentley right here in. Pick your fabric out. Now, other than BMW, you have to, you know, you do it online. It's rarely going to go to a BMW dealer. You get to actually pick out your leathers. Pick out your interior. Here you have, I'm just going to pull, I hope this is cool. Look at this. This is unbelievable. And more than likely, they'll probably, look at this. Oh, check this out. This is a poster of the race car. So what they'll probably do is have you sit here and custom make your car. All right? So if you're going to do it, you want to do it right. I was talking to my man the other day, and I was telling him that if you're going to buy a high-end car, don't buy a high-end car and not get everything loaded in the car because you can't afford it. If you buy the high-end car, and it comes with fog lights, then get the fog lights. Don't, you know, skimp on the fog lights. If it comes with a head-up display, don't skimp on the head-up display. Buy that. Don't buy it then. Just wait. Why buy a car that doesn't have everything in it, and then either at the end of your lease or at the end of your sale, and you're ready to get rid of the car, and you're into your terms, and you're done with it, then you're not going to get as much money for that car. Because it doesn't have anything in it. Now, normally they don't pay you for the accessories that you have in the car, but of course it has to, you know, when you look at Kelley Blue Book, is included in your Kelley Blue Book estimation of how much the car costs. They ask you, do you have DVD? They ask you, do you have certain things in your car? So you want to have that. When I bought my BMW, it has everything. It's fully loaded. Head-up display, 5 cameras, 2 on the mirror, 2 on the front bumpers, just like this Rolls, like this Bentley. 2 on the front bumper and 1 in the back. I have 5 cameras. I have a head-up display. Everything is fully loaded. DVD, everything is in my car. Because I'm going to buy the car, I'm going to get it loaded. I'm not going to get a car and then get cheap on the car. Buy the car and you put anything you need to put in the car and you keep it pushing. All right, this is a Bentley. And I want to, you know, it's going to be a long video. I hope you guys are interested as I am. $351,000. It's called a Mulsanne. And I think that's it, Mulsanne. And beautiful car. Black on black. Black interior. Regular handles. I don't think they really deal with the suicide doors here in Bentley. So they don't deal with the suicide doors. And it's a beautiful car. Again, another car, but this one seems to be a cream gut. I used to call them camel or cream guts. And you have the screen. This is another addition I have in my car. I have the screens in the back of my car. So, you know, I can screen out my back windows. I don't have the ones all the way in the back, but they had the ones in the back as well. I think only the 7 series and maybe some 5 series come all the way wrapped around with the one in the back and the one on the back windows. My BMW, my X5 diesel only has the back windows, not the rear window, okay? And this again, I think is a Mulsanne. This is a Flying Spark, okay? And this price is $219. So, you know, look at that, it's such a difference. And these two cars are, you know, like the new ones up there, I think they have had a new one, well, used one back there that costs more than this one. But this is $219 new out the box. I'm not saying that like it's easy, like, oh yeah. Now I can even buy a tire. You know what I mean? The tire is my car payment. So, no, we ain't going to do that. But I just wanted, like I said, again, expose you guys to some finer cars since I was in the area. And I want to make sure that you guys got to see this. Because I get excited about seeing cars, even cars I know I possibly never had. This is my car right here. This is it. This is the one I want if I get one. Convertible. Cream gut. Perforated gut. Perforated seats front and back. Okay, pearl white, and if I'm not mistaken, if I got my top would be the same color as the interior, a cream top. This is my car. This is the one I may want one day when I'm in a position. I probably won't want a W12. I don't want a 12 cylinder. It's gonna be kind of hard on gas, but this is the car. This is my vehicle that I would like to have one day if I'm in position, and no other way but in position. Okay, next we have a brand new. This is a V8, which is, can't get any lower than that. It's either 12s or 8s. It's a Continental GT as well, so I mean it bumps. And the price on this is an affordable $198,000. That's minus tax. Maybe you can work the tax in? I'm not sure. If you got a problem with tax, you better go to Delaware. I don't think they have a luxury car dealership in Delaware like this, okay? So a beautiful car as well. I'm just about done. I'm gonna come up here again. Beautiful color. Burgundy. This is a V12, of course, Flying Spur. And again, it says, as powerful as this is, luxurious.
John, good morning, it's Anthony over at Anderson Turbo.
And here you have your perforated seats. Unbelievable. The interior is great. I am not going to open up any car doors. I don't need doing that. You guys, you know, you can go online and go to the website and really see the interior if that's what you want to see. You can see the interiors of the car there. I don't really want to be opening cars whatsoever because I'm not buying it. I'm not even test driving it, so I'm not going to do that. And once again, the last car on the list for the day for you guys is going to be the Continental GTC V8, which is a totally different vehicle. Of course, GTC means it's probably just a bump a bit faster in horsepower. So pretty much you have to consider that when it comes to your insurance, because the faster the car, the more your insurance is going to be. It's going to be hard to insure the car if you can't afford to get into this car. And if you can't afford the insurance, then you have no business trying to buy the car. That's what it comes down to. Now, I mean, there comes a time that you live beyond your means, and you live beyond your means just enough to get what you got to get. And then there's just taking a chance on economic ruin, and you attempt to get one of these. But you know what? You'll be brought right down to earth when you talk to the bank. So you can dream about it. Here, you're not even test driving these. They don't get down like that unless you already been pre-approved for the vehicle. Just like a house. You can't go walking through a mansion and you only been pre-approved for a $23,000 house. So you can't just come here and say, I'm gonna test drive. Can I test drive? No, you can't do that. That's not what's happening. Last but not least, we're gonna take you to, bam, I know you didn't see that coming. I know you didn't see that coming. In the Kanye's car, Kanye has this all blacked out. This is the boy right here. Insuring this would be nearly impossible in Philadelphia. You would have to claim an illegal address somewhere in Copacabana, Egypt, okay, to get any kind of insurance rates on this car. This car is, read it for yourself because I don't want to mispronounce it. And not the Aventus, okay? It's the Aventador. Aventador. And we're just going to humble ourselves just to look at the price. Can you see it? I don't want to see it. It's like $530,000, okay? Kim Kardashian gave, I don't see how that happens because she don't make no money like that anymore. But Kim Kardashian supposedly gave Kanye one of these. His all blacked out joint. I'm sure he helped. She probably put the down payment down on it. And then he just finished it up. Because she ain't making the payments. Because, well, there probably ain't no payments. Okay? And now we have, it's almost similar to the Aventor in a way, but I doubt if it's an Aventor. This looks as if it is looking for a model. Don't see the model name. And it don't matter anyway. Because you ain't getting it. That's right. It's already sold. Here you have your products. Here you can get to, look at those rotors. Can you imagine how much one of them rotors cost? Now, when I had my Porsche, my Boxster S, the rotor was $800. This is a Lamborghini, okay? Look at the tire. Now, some of you may know, like I kind of know, that you can't drive a Lamborghini really on a Philly street because you'll tear it up. You have to at least be going 60 miles an hour for most of these vehicles to really open up. You can't continue to drive them at 30 miles an hour. You just can't. You can, but you better get on the highway real quick. You just can't do it. You know what I mean? And these cars, if I'm not mistaken, you don't worry about having DVD displays and all that. No, you got too much to worry about to be worried about whether these have DVD players in them for the kids. It's just not even that kind of game right here. It's your luxury car. That's what it is. This is Lamborghini. Now, there you go. We do have a screen there for navigation. I wouldn't have time looking for navigation because I ain't going to where I'm going anyway. You got me? Beautiful car, red. I'm not sure what the name of this one is. We'll take a look at this and then we're going to be on our way out to head to pick up our Hamilton watch for the day. In the meantime, this is a beautiful black Lamborghini. But let's get the name. Let's be consistent. Let's keep it pushing. The name of this vehicle is going to be Let's see if we can find it. This is an Aventador as well. I should have known by the open pouch there to cool them brakes down. Yeah, indeed. This is a sexy car right here. This is a two-door, of course. It's not a four-door. But look at the back of this car. Open display, open back display, like an automatic watch. You got an open engine display. Where are you going to park this? Can I park this in my garage where I live at, even though I'm in a garage? And this is actually used. So you see we have a warranty here, previous damage, repair, vehicle history, bada, bada, bing, bada, bada, boom. This is Gallardo. I test drove one of these before, and I also got a chance to take one around the track. So I do know how this feels. But the one I test drove was 560 horsepower. And I think this is a 550, okay. I drove a LP562, 10,000 miles. Just traded for a McLaren Spyder. Unbelievable. 164,000. You might be able to get into that, okay? So look at it this way. Divide 3 into 164,000. Okay? Because 3 in 100, that's about the average price of the car you're probably driving. I mean, maybe. Or maybe let's divide that by 4, $40,000. Now quadruple your salary. And then you can grab one of those, okay? You can buy, you can be riding around with this. That's quadruple what your payment is, what you're doing now. So if your payment is $400, $1,200, because you got good credit, you might be able to get that. Can you afford the warranty? Can you afford the insurance? The insurance is going to be the payment. You got me? This is a 2007 Ferrari 430 Spyder F1. No warranty. So when you come up off this, is previous damage repair, whatever. I'm sure it's not something major when it comes to these cars. Because they wouldn't even take it if they knew they couldn't push it out. No warranty. You got to get your own warranty. That beautiful Ferrari engine. Look at that. Unbelievable. Okay. Here you have your vent. Your vent is up top for the brakes here. Right up, right above the door handle. Okay. Not down low. Even though you do have a vent down here. So maybe you do. Maybe you have a double. What the? This is for the engine, knucklehead. Okay. And that's for your brakes. Rotors and calipers. Unbelievable. Yeah, I can see where the problem was. It's in the hood, like I can see the repaint. And it also has, you see that line right there? So it has a front end, protector. Because you do want to have a front end protector when you have these vehicles. Because once again, to insure it would be one thing. To get it prepared is a whole nother situation. All right, so that's it, y'all. I'm about to be out. Ferrari, Lamborghini, Bentley, Rolls Royce. Thanks to FC Kerbeck. And the managers, Joe and Sarah, for being so kind to me, allowing me to come up here and take a look at these cars and invite you guys in. As you see, you can sit here while you're waiting. You may just want to come in here and sit down, period. You have a model cars here. If you want to grab one on the way out, you know what I mean? Probably like about $200 to $300 a pop. I've seen those in one of the, I think it's called Touch of Modern or Modern Touch, something like that, where they sell these cars. And I've seen the price. Like I said, it's anywhere from $100 to $500 for these model cars, and they're pretty detailed. I mean, these details down to the engine and everything, some of these, so very cool if that's what you want to do. Lamborghini sign, again, I want to thank FC Kerbeck for allowing me to come in here with no problem. They told me to enjoy myself. Don't forget to pick up your Rob report, okay? You got to have that. Get a subscription to Rob report, because though you may not be able to afford these things, it doesn't hurt to look at them. It doesn't hurt to look at these things. And not really necessarily dream, because you just have to have it, or you just, you know, hook a crook, you want to rob a bank or whatever to get one of these. But it's just good to look at nice things that you're entitled, you know, not you're entitled to, but, you know, it is available to you if you want to grab one. But there's nothing wrong with looking at some things. Just don't lust at them. Just don't do anything to make you do something crooked to try to get one. All right? Because I think my man, Cool C, who's about to be executed January, killed that police officer in North Philly, Rising Sun Avenue. Got arrested, you know. He couldn't wait for, understand, he couldn't wait for his money. The song had already went platinum, The Glamorous Life. Now that guy's about to die because he couldn't wait for his money. He went to rob a bank, him and his boys, and now he got the death penalty, and now he got to pay. It might have been because he wanted to get a Rolls Royce. It might have been because he wanted something. He wanted a gold necklace. Maybe he wanted a platinum chain. Maybe he was going to get in the trappings of success. What he didn't realize is it's more to success in the music business than just making a great song. There's some other things you have to do to ensure that you get paid. And y'all know what it's usually called, okay? You gotta sell something. You just ain't getting it for free. And that's how you take these cars down. They move them around, put them in the garage for the cars on here, and they take them down, take them out, and let you drive them. But again, you got to be pre-approved. You got to be ready to buy. Can't be sitting up here and, you know, you better put some money down. You had to put down probably the equivalent of what you paid for your car just to get this, just to get a hold on it. So we're talking about maybe $10,000. Just to get it on the Yameen. That's a shame. I can see a very light scratch on this car. I'm not sure whether it's new or not, but you can see it. I would have a fit if I saw that on my car. A fit. I would call the cops ASAP. Okay? But let's keep it positive. All right, y'all. Y'all have a happy holiday. I hope y'all enjoyed this tour of FC Kerbeck, the luxury car division, upstairs on the second floor. If you come through New Jersey, you come over to Tacoma Palmyra Bridge. You can see it from right there. And here we go. I'll give you the number. That's Lamborghini, Palmyra, New Jersey. FC Kerbeck, 1-800-KERBECK. And all of these cars are a part of the FC Kerbeck stable. They are authorized dealers of these vehicles. Authorized deals. Y'all know what it is. Authorized dealers of watches are not always authorized dealers. You know how it is. FC Kerbeck is authorized dealer. He's been here for years. Okay? I'm about to be out. Holla at your boy. Ride it real deep. Cool. Now it's go to time to go pick up that timepiece. Holla at your boy. Hope y'all enjoyed this. Take care. Bye-bye. Elevate it down.